Hello everybody, Fiasco back again today from Epcot, my favorite park. And what I want to do today at my favorite park is do my favorite types of rides. By the time you're watching this intro, I actually already went through my little science project here. But the idea of this video today was I wanted to see, showing up as Epcot opened at 11 a.m., how many attractions could I accomplish? And what that kind of morphed into was showing up at Epcot as it opened, can I do all the boat rides in an hour? Did I succeed? We're about to find out, but before we do, let me remind you all these videos are brought to you by Dreams Unlimited Travel. Our travel experts are standing by right now to help you plan the perfect vacation. All that information and more can be found down in the description below. But to start off our video today, we are booking it directly to Frozen at 11 a.m. to see, can we get right on? Let's go. You don't see this often. 15-minute posted wait time. Cast member said it should only be about 10 minutes though. Let's do it. I actually cannot tell you the last time I rode this attraction because, well, the wait's always just craziness. So this is a pleasant surprise right at park open.
Wandering Elk here. Happy summer snow day from me to you.
Yeah.
So that was essentially a walk-on, surprisingly, and as I'm exiting it, it's still posted 15-minute wait. Between me getting in line to go on and me boarding the boat, it was about 8 minutes. So, like, for Frozen, if you know that's insanely fast. Now I'm going to backpedal a little bit and see how quickly I can get on Grand Fiesta Boat Tour, one of my faves. Usually not a long wait anyways, but we're trying to see how much we can squeeze into the first hour in the park here, so let's make it happen. So I can easily remember the last time I did this. It was the last time I was at Epcot, because I do it like every time I come. And lo and behold, we have another walk-on. We're just walking right on. Gotta love it.
Bienvenidos. For your safety, we may consider keeping your hands, arms, feet, and legs inside the boat. And if you have children with you, please watch them. Gracias.
Bienvenidos. Para su seguridad, permanezca sentado.
Oh my God. time of war! Look out!
So that one was an immediate walk on to. The only time that it took was the time it took to walk up there. There was one party in front of me that did end up filling up that entire boat. And if you noticed in the video I just took, there was a completely empty boat in front of us. So I would have actually got in my very own boat. There was nobody behind me for a good like 60 seconds. But they used that opportunity of me being the only one in line to do the boat reset, which I would do the same thing, I totally understand. But I almost did have my own boat. That's how little people run to Grand Fiesta at the beginning of Epcot opening. But I think we should have time for some more stuff. So let's head over to the land. And I'm sure you can already tell this isn't the most efficient way of hitting the attractions, unless of course Frozen is a priority. And I kind of wanted to make Frozen a priority today, seeing as I really never do it. I mean, I feel like it's probably been over a year since I rode Frozen. Just because it's never worth the wait for me. But if I can rope drop it and get in there in 10 minutes, well, that's what we'll do. So that actually worked out perfect. But granted, you could probably do more attractions if your rope drop target was something like Test Track or Soarin', because it's closer to the front of the park, and then you can work your way back more efficiently that way. And we're kind of doing a backpedal here, but it's all right. Let's go live with the land. And we love to see it. 5 minute posted wait time. People are all piling in now, but still looks relatively fast. Still think it's definitely probably around 5 minutes.
The tropics are home to the greatest diversity of plants on the planet. Many of these, like papaya, bananas, cacao, coffee, and rice, are well known around the world. These are just a few of the edible plants that have been an important source of nutrition for people living in the tropics. Many are rich in vitamins and minerals, while others are well adapted to growing in less than ideal conditions. Some, like the water lily, thrive in wet, swampy areas and waterways.
All right, everybody, that was our hour. The hour actually elapsed as we were on Living with the Land around the greenhouse area. That's where the hour mark passed. But what do you think of my hair? I was thinking the other day that I should go get a haircut, but then I was like, you know what? Pete always says I'm a tree-hugging hippie. Why don't I fully embrace it, let the hair grow out nice and long? I've never done it before, so comment down below. What should I do with my hair? Get a haircut or let it grow? But yeah, that was our hour. We set out to do all the attractions that I wanted to do. Well, all the boat attractions is really what we accomplished. We did all the boat rides at Epcot in an hour. We showed up at 11 a.m. when the park opened. Some people were definitely here earlier, because you can get here earlier, be there at like 10:30 and just wait around so you can get there even quicker. But we didn't do that. We leisurely strolled in at 11 a.m., made a beeline straight to Frozen, got right on. Did Grand Fiesta Tour, got right on. Did Living with the Land, you know, waited like 5 minutes, but got right on all of them. And it took about an hour to do all of that, so that was cool. And that was fun. But leave comments down below, not just about my hair, but what you would do as Epcot opened. What attractions are you hitting first? What's your plan to get the most done before lunch at Epcot? I'd love to know, and I'm sure everybody else would love to know. And other than that, that's pretty much it. And yeah, I'll see you in the next one. Make sure you subscribe for future videos like this from me, the other team members. Make sure you subscribe for more. And I'll see you in the next one.